place before it, our failed attempts, our worries, our anxieties, and our accomplishments. Let us offer them to the Lord that he might grace them and that he might provide for us what we need. Lord Jesus, you are bread for the hungry. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you are water for the thirsty. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are light for those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us. And grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the second book of Kings. A man came from Baal-Shalisha, bringing to Elijah, the man of God, 20 barley loaves made from the first fruits and fresh grain in the ear. Elijah said, "Give it to the people to eat." But his servant objected, "How can I set this before 100 people?" Elijah insisted, "Give it to the people to eat. For thus says the Lord, they shall eat, and there shall be some left over." And when they had eaten, there was some left over, as the Lord had said. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
will praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will give you glory, my God above, and I will bless your name forever. Every day I will bless and praise your name forever. I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God. The Lord is full of graceful mercy. He is kind and slow to anger. God is good in every way and full of compassion. I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let all the faithful bless you. Let them speak of your might, O Lord, the glory of your kingdom. I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God. The Lord is faithful in word and deed, and always near. God's name is holy, lifting up all those who fall. God raises up the lowly. I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace, one body and one Spirit, as you are also called to the one hope of your call, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all, and through all, and in all. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Speak, O Lord, your servant is listening. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
With your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus went across the Sea of Galilee. A large crowd followed him, because they saw the signs he was performing on the sick. Jesus went up the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. Now the Jewish feast of Passover was near. When Jesus raised his eyes and saw that a large crowd was coming to him, he said to Philip, "Where can we buy enough food for them to eat?" He said this to test him, but because he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 200 days' wages worth of food would not be enough for each of them to have a little." One of his disciples, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, said to him, "There's a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, but what good are these for so many?" Jesus said, "Have the people recline." Now there was a great deal of grass in that place, so the people reclined, about 5,000 in number. Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks, and distributed them to those who were reclining, and also much of the fish as they wanted. When they had had their fill, he said to his disciples, "Gather the fragments left over so that nothing will be wasted." So they collected them and filled 12 wicker baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves that had been more than they could eat. When the people saw the sign he had done, they said, "This is truly the prophet, the one who is to come into the world." Since Jesus knew that they were going to come and carry him off to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain alone. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Don't you love a story with a happy ending? I think it's why people like this miracle story of the multiplication of loaves and fish. It always has a happy ending. No matter which gospel writer is writing the story, keep in mind this is one of the few stories that all 4 gospel writers include in their gospel. Matthew and Mark love the story so much they have it in there twice. They have Jesus performing the miracle not once, but on 2 different occasions. They love the story so much because, of course, it has an incredibly happy ending. All 8 and were satisfied. But is that really the miracle? This story that we've heard God knows how many times, that we've heard priests preach on God knows how many times, is the story, the miracle of the multiplication of loaves and fish, is the miracle in the multiplication? Is the miracle in the fact that all ate and were satisfied? Or is the miracle really to be found at the end of the story? It's a great question for us to reflect on. I must confess to you, my friends, that I too have read this story countless times. I've preached on it countless times, but for some reason, this past week, as I was reflecting on this story and preparing for this weekend's homily, it's the end of the story that grabbed my attention. I think it's where the real miracle is. The end of the story reads, Jesus instructing the disciples to gather the fragments that are left over so that nothing will be wasted. Could it be that that's the real miracle? Or at least the potential for the miracle to happen? It happens in the gathering of the fragments. Our life is much like that, isn't it? It's a bunch of fragments. Oh, we would like our lives to be different. We would like our lives to be whole and to be complete and to be, why, full. And yet we realize that our life is a bunch of fragments. It's a series of this and that. Why, our days are filled with fragments. There's a small accomplishment here. There's a frustration over here. There's perhaps a bit of anger that creeps up over here, and why our days are filled with these little pieces of fragment called life. And Jesus invites the disciples, as he invites you and I, to get on our hands and knees and to gather the fragments. I'm guessing the disciples had to do that. At least they had to bend over to pick up those fragments that had been left behind, because Jesus wants nothing to go to waste. He's not simply concerned about the food there, that it not go to waste. He's concerned, my friends, that our lives won't be considered that, that these fragments that make up our day, each and every day, might not be considered by us as waste, but rather that we might gather them together. It's that ability that has been taught to us since children at the end of a day to have that examination of our conscience. It's coming to the end of the day. It's gathering all these fragments together and realizing that when we do, why, all of a sudden this basket becomes full. And an image is revealed. And it becomes complete. And the fragments reveal this most incredible image, and that is the image of God himself. It's why Paul tells us in today's second reading that there is one God who is over all and through all and in all. My friends, that includes the fragments. God is found over all, through all, and in all. It's why we have to gather the fragments together, because in gathering the fragments, we then bring those fragments and we join them together once again with the source which is God himself, that feeds us in the midst of those fragmented lives that are ours, and nourishes us, and it's in the fragments, and it's when we bring them all together that we realize that they're not a waste at all, but rather it is what defines us, it is what makes us whole, it can be what makes us complete if only we undertake the work, like the disciples did, of getting on bended knee and gathering together that which makes up our lives, our accomplishments, our fears, those things that have defined this particular day or the next, It is, my friends, where God can be found. In the midst of the fragments that you and I gather together today. And then once we realize how full that basket becomes, why then we're not afraid. We're not afraid to share the fragments that define our lives with the people around us. And we share them freely, and we share them unselfishly, and we share them abundantly, and why we experience the miracle again and again and again, where everyone eats and everyone is satisfied, so that in turn everyone might experience the miracle, the true miracle of the multiplications of loaves and fish. A miracle that happens in the gathering. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, and not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate to the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us turn to the Lord our God, who is our food and our nourishment, as we offer in prayer and petition the needs of this church gathered here today.
That the Eucharist will be available to all Catholics throughout the world and be celebrated as a gift that brings heaven and earth together, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those with power and authority work to feed the hungry, protect the innocent, and nurture our environment, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That each member of our area faith community will commit to helping the oppressed and suffering, as well as those who are hungry for peace, justice, dignity, and acceptance. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who work directly to feed others, farmers and grocers, cooks and dietitians, gardeners and restaurant workers, will be blessed for their service. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and dying be comforted, and that those who have died, especially Wayne Zimmerman and Daniel Verhelst, will be fed at the eternal banquet in heaven. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our written and unspoken prayers will be answered according to God's will. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, you are the giver of every gift. We thank you for the gifts of bread and wine that become for us the food, the nourishment that we seek and need this day. May it fill our hearts. May it reveal and continue to reveal your presence in our world through our own thoughts, words, and actions. Help us as we gather this day to be that presence of your Son. Hear our petitions, answer them according to your will, for we ask them through Christ our Lord. and invite our children to bring their offerings forward at this time.
Our song for the preparation of the gifts is number 374 in the Breaking Bread, the Servant's Song, number 374. Will you let me be your servant? Let me be as Christ in you. Pray that I may have the grace to let you be my servant too. We are pilgrims on a journey. We are travelers on the road. We are here to help each other walk the mile and bear the load. I will hold the Christ light for you in the night time of your fear. I will hold my hand out to you. Speak the peace you long to hear. I will weep when you are weeping. When you laugh, I'll laugh with you. I will share your joy and sorrow till we've seen this journey through. When we sing to God in heaven, we shall find such harmony. Born of all we've known together, of Christ's love and agony. Let me be your servant, let me be as Christ to you. Pray that I may have the grace to let you be my servant too.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, our good and all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord. And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin Mary. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, with all the clergy and with all your people. Remember our sisters and our brothers who have died in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Together we pray for our daily bread as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let us share the gift of peace with one another.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those now called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song today is number 640 in the Breaking Bread. Blessed are they, number 640.
Blessed are they, the poor in spirit. Theirs is the kingdom of God. Blessed are they, full of sorrow. They shall be consoled. Rejoice and be glad. Blessed are you, holy are you, rejoice and be glad. Yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are they, the lowly ones, they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst. They shall have their fill. Rejoice and be glad. Blessed are you, holy are you, rejoice and be glad. Yours is the kingdom. kingdom of God. Blessed are they who show mercy, mercy shall be theirs. Blessed are they, the pure of heart, they shall see God. Rejoice and be glad. Blessed are you, holy are you, rejoice and be glad. Yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are they who seek peace, they are the children of God. Blessed are they who suffer in faith, the glory of God is theirs. Rejoice and be glad. Blessed are you, holy are you, rejoice and be glad. Yours is the kingdom of God.
Let us pray. We have received, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is now ended. Let us go in peace.
Our sending forth song this afternoon is number 641, Lead Me, Lord, number 641.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, longing for their Lord, for God's coming kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are the sorrowing, for they shall be consoled, and the meek shall come to rule the world. Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord, by the light of truth, to seek and to find the narrow way. Be my way, be my truth, be my life, my Lord, and lead me, Lord, today. Blessed are the merciful, for mercy shall be theirs, and the pure in heart shall see their God. Blessed are they whose hunger only holiness can fill, for I say they shall be satisfied. Lead me, Lord, by the light of truth, to seek and to find the narrow way. Be my way, be my truth, be my life, my Lord, and lead me, Lord, today. Blessed are they who through their lifetime sow the seeds of peace. All will call them children of the Lord. Blessed are you, though persecuted in your holy life, for in heaven great is your reward. Lead me, Lord, by the light of truth, to seek and to find the narrow way. Be my truth, be my life, my Lord, and lead me, Lord, today. And lead me, Lord, today.